Everybody, I hope you enjoyed that beautiful sunrise. We just arrived about an hour ago to the city of Havana in Cuba. The ship just docked. We're at the port. I got up early this morning so I could do a little bit of recording for you guys and really just get to enjoy these beautiful sunrises and sunsets that I personally really enjoy when I go on a cruise. But I thought I would pan around and show you guys the harbor real quick. And then I'm gonna go back down to the room and start getting ready. And we're gonna go out into the city today and bring you guys along with us for a fun adventure in the city of Havana, Cuba. But just to give you guys kind of a perspective of where I am, I thought it'd be kind of fun just to show you the deck real quick. Ooh, the sun is really bright. Look at the sun. Isn't that beautiful? But yeah, we're really excited to explore the city. And then right over there, I thought that was kind of interesting. It looks like a old light wall and a fort. And you can see way down on the end there, on the point, that looks like a lighthouse. And there's like some sort of barge that's going out into the ocean. You can see it down there. And then over there is some sort of old wall. It looks like a fort. But this is the terminal that we're located at. And it says Terminal Sierra Maestra. Here we are, the city of Havana.
Voy a cantar esta canción con mucho cariño de mi corazón a la República Dominicana, la casa del merengue y la casa de la bachata. Voy a cantar esta canción con mucho cariño de mi corazón a la República Dominicana, la casa del merengue, la casa de la bachata. La 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 la, la casa del merengue. La 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 la, y la casa de la bachata.
We are in Old Havana, and immediately we are struck by the classic cars, the incredible architecture, and the sense of immediately immersing yourselves in a culture the second you step off the boat. We are so thrilled to be here. Behind us, all around us, is Plaza de San Francisco, one of the classic squares in the city.
So what is it about Havana that's so enticing to so many people? Is it the culture, the history, the resilient nature of the awesome Cuban people? Yes, all of the above. This basilica was built in 1608, and the magnificent fountain right in front, Fuente de los Leones, was carved by an Italian sculptor named Giuseppe Gagini in 1836. Next to the basilica is a serene garden that's dedicated to Mother Teresa. And this building right here, it's an office building now, but before the revolution, this place was the home of Cuba's stock exchange. We visited Havana in April 2019. Only a few months later, a new travel ban had already been put in place, so thankfully we were able to get one brief day in this amazing city. Havana was settled by the Spaniards in 1515, and it was officially founded as a city in 1592. It's one of the Caribbean's most significant port cities, and its history is littered with violent attacks by buccaneers and pirates. Here on the Malecon, Havana's iconic seaside highway, we see all these classic cars. After the Revolution, American cars could no longer be imported, so the people had to be resourceful with what they already had.
Here we are at Plaza de la Catedral. Beautiful cathedral behind us. We're looking forward to seeing this historic square, meeting some folks, and immersing ourselves in that awesome Havana culture. Here we go.
In Havana, there are ridiculously narrow streets, ridiculously cute Havana street dogs, and also some pretty cool street art. Check out this alien skull sort of thing coming up on the right. This is just one example of the rebellious spirit you get a sense of when you're walking through this city. We stumbled onto a park where a woman was taking care of the local feral cats and making sure they were looking healthy. I'm not quite sure what they're doing here, but I'm gonna say it's very beneficial for this kitten. Anyway, we were happy that these cats were being so well fed, and that made us realize that we were very, very hungry. And so we started heading towards our lunch destination. It's important to support independently owned restaurants when you're visiting Cuba. Thankfully, we found the perfect spot, a legendary local paladar. Paladares are independently run restaurants, and often people run them out of their home. Once they were legalized in the 90s, Cuban cuisine really started to blow up. All the stuffy government-run restaurants had a lot of healthy competition, like this one, the place where we ate, Paladar Doña Eutimia, one of the best paladares in the city. Inaugurated in 1923, this used to be the fabulous presidential palace, but after the Cuban Revolution in the 1950s, it became the Museum of the Revolution. The Cubans seem to really like Italian sculptors because here's yet another impressive statue created by an Italian, Aldo Gamba. The monument pays homage to General Máximo Gómez. There's a wonderful study in contrast on display in Cuba. Mid-century cars parked in front of centuries-old forts and monuments, modern city life, curious yellow vehicles. Check this out. Anyway, after a nice long day of interacting with the locals and immersing ourselves in Cuban culture, we were ready to re-immerse ourselves in the ultimate beverage package that awaited us back on our cruise ship. Bye, Havana. We will never forget you. Thank you.
leave a comment to say hi. If you like us, please subscribe. And if you don't, our little fluffy dog will attack you.